I'm Seth Meyers. This is Late Night. We hope you're doing well. And now, if you don't mind, we're going to get to the news. A federal appeals court ruled today that former President Donald Trump is not immune from prosecution for crimes he allegedly committed during his presidency. Okay, so he doesn't have immunity, but after all these trials, he must have built up some antibodies. While speaking today about the Senate's bipartisan immigration bill, President Biden said Republican lawmakers need to ask themselves, quote, who do they serve, Donald Trump or the American people? And Republican lawmakers said they'll get back to him on that. They just have to make a quick phone call. No, sir. I understand. It was a dumb question. Former Trump White House aide Anthony Scaramucci said in a new interview that if Trump is forced to pay $370 million in damages for his civil fraud case, he may have to liquidate assets or take on loans, which would be crazy. Because Trump hasn't had to do that since the 70s, 80s, 90s, 2000s, 2010s, 2020s, and a few times last week. According to a new poll, more voters are concerned about President Biden's age than about former President Trump's multiple felony charges. Are you kidding me right now? What are you so worried Biden's going to do? Send you a check for $5 on your birthday? You're more worried about 81 years than you are about 91 felony charges. And by the way, he's not a young criminal. He's not being charged with unlawful parkour. He's only 3 years younger than Biden. They both remember the first time they saw a color TV. The only difference is Trump probably stole his. According to new reports, Vice President Kamala Harris regularly watches Fox News, which is how she found out she's been pronouncing her name wrong. Yeah. It's one worth thinking about. I'm not saying you're ever gonna like it. I'll wait. Presidential candidate Nikki Haley said yesterday that she's requested Secret Service protection because then at least there will be a couple of people at her rallies. We're on a roll. A new study has proposed adding a Category 6 designation to the hurricane intensity scale. The study included an illustration of what the aftermath might look like. After it was announced that the final match of the 2026 FIFA World Cup will be held in East Rutherford, New Jersey, New York Mayor Eric Adams told reporters yesterday that FIFA, quote, clearly saw the fan experience here and clearly didn't see Penn Station. According to a new survey, Ruth's Chris Steakhouse was voted the country's favorite restaurant chain. Great news for either Ruth or Chris or both. I don't know. I never understood what that name was. The NYPD has announced that the police robot that was tasked with patrolling a Times Square subway station has been retired. Apparently, they caught him stealing cocaine from the evidence room. And finally, a Catholic priest yesterday blessed an MTA tunnel construction site in New York, 55 feet below Grand Central Terminal, while the L train was finally given an exorcism. And that was a monologue, everybody. We are all We got a great show for you tonight. She's an 80s film icon who's currently starring in Feud, Capote versus the Swans. Molly Ringwald will be here. Good night, everybody. She is a sportscaster whose podcast, Up and Adams, airs weekday mornings on FanDuel TV. Kay Adams will be joining us, everybody. And he is a New York Times best-selling author and a favorite here at Late Night. His novel, Chain Gang All-Stars, is available now in paperback. Nana Kwame Adegbenye will be here. Also, my brother and I, we got ourselves a podcast. We got a new guest this week. Check out Mo Ammer. He's a very funny comedian. He's got a fantastic life story that he shares with us. It's a really good listen, so check it out. You guys, moving on. Here at Late Night, every night, I deliver a monologue made up of jokes written by a diverse team of writers. As a result, a lot of jokes come across my desk that, due to my being a straight white male, would be difficult for me to deliver, but we don't think that should stop you from enjoying them. So we'd like to share them with you now in a segment called Joke Seth Can't Tell. Hey, guys, these are two of our writers, Amber and Jenny.
I'm black.
And I'm gay.
And we're both women.
And I'm not. So here's how it works. I'll read the setups to these jokes, and Amber and Jenny will then read the punchlines. Here we go. The website Mashable recently published a list of the best dating apps for lesbians.
Or if you want to meet a lesbian, just get your oil changed.
An elementary school in Chicago received a visit from the first black astronaut to walk in space.
Said the astronaut, bad news, it's racist up there, too.
Now, Amber, what makes you think space is racist?
People go up there and play golf.
Makes sense. The Gay Games, an Olympic-style event for queer athletes, kicked off recently with events like softball, golf, and powerlifting.
And also some sports for men. Hey, Seth, I competed in the Gay Games.
Oh, really? What was your event?
Parallel parking.
Great. The Philadelphia Zoo recently hired their first black CEO.
Because their white CEO kept letting the animals kiss him on the mouth.
Now, Amber, would you let a dog kiss you on the mouth?
I don't know. He got a job.
The website Autostraddle recently published a history of lesbian vampire movies.
A lesbian vampire is like a straight vampire, but if you invite them into your house, they move in permanently.
According to a new study, when black women work with white coworkers, they have worse job outcomes.
This story first reported by a black woman working at Talbot's.
Now, Amber, have you ever shopped at a Talbot's?
No, but according to security, I have stolen from them.
Okay. Lifetime has released a new thriller about a lesbian couple who goes camping in a small town.
The suspense comes from finding out which one of them will end up running for mayor. I tried.
Yeah, sometimes. Sometimes I trust when you're like, trust me, this is the thing lesbians do. They run for mayor. And I'm like, all right.
What, have you ever met a mayor who wasn't a lesbian?
I've barely met any lesbians who aren't mayors.
I have a sash on under this.
The first ever Florida Man Games will be held next year and will include an event called the Evading Arrest Obstacle Course.
So congratulations to the winner, a white woman crying.
No, why is she crying?
Starbucks is out of oat milk.
Okay. A lesbian couple recently sent one of their extra wedding invitations to Barack and Michelle Obama and received a letter back from them.
It said, you have too many cats.
Now, Jenny, would you date a woman with a cat?
I don't know. She got a job?
According to a recent study, black Americans are less likely to attend Alcoholics Anonymous meetings than white Americans.
It's easier for white people to be anonymous because they all look the same.
It's true. Yeah, that's funny because it's true.
All right.
Hey, Seth, why don't you tell one?
Oh, God.
Seth, please, just one.
Oh, I don't feel like it'll work out if I do it.
Oh, come on, do it. Oh,
okay. A new public radio station is launching in Illinois that will amplify black voices. Or if you really want to hear black voices amplified, go to the movies.
Yeah! Oh my God!
I'm so sorry. Allow me to rectify the situation.
Okay. All right.
A lesbian couple was recently thrown out of an Australian casino for kissing. Hey, just be glad they didn't go down under.
How dare you?
You're just mad because I told the best one. I'm a better lesbian comedian than you are, Madam Mayor.
You should be ashamed
of
yourself.
I'm proud of myself.
Don't be proud.
Be quiet. This isn't a movie theater.
Oh, she's dead. Oh, no. Oh, you guys, she's dead.
Oh, no. I just want to apologize as the mayor of this studio.
Black women and lesbians are liars.